Hey y'all, what's up? Yeah, I've been trying to get it set up and streaming on Kick, and for some reason it's not working through StreamYard. So that's okay. We'll just play it as is. I'm on Twitch, YouTube, and Twitter, so that should be, and Rumble as well. So should be good. Yeah, just wanted to jump on. Play a little bit. I've been meaning to get into Hogwarts Legacy for a little while now. So yeah, just let's hang out, let's play. I bought this game quite a while ago, and so actually let me put it on the screen. Right. Yeah, I actually bought this game quite a while ago. Shoot. One second. So bought it quite a while ago, wanted to play it. But then I realized, like, when it first came out, I only have an Xbox One. And so I was like, I couldn't, like, it didn't come out right away for Xbox One. So that's why we're playing it so late. And then I haven't typically played video games for that in quite a while,
Father from London and the carriage traveled.
I just realized my name's spelled wrong on
Somewhere
here.
in the Scottish
But I
Highlands,
just started, so you guys will get
they
to go through
say,
the
do you
whole
think he
series,
was
the whole
meant to
game.
meet us there?
It'll be good.
I do. This has not been the day either of us expected. But Miriam sent that portkey to George for a reason. And I believe that she, and now George, died in pursuit of whatever it was meant to lead to. If you're sure you're all right and wouldn't mind indulging me, I'd like to have a look around.
Absolutely, sir.
Good. Let's see if we can find a path, however faded it may be. Mind your step.
Hey, Catherine.
Where do you suppose your wife got the portkey that brought us here?
A good question. Miriam spent years searching for evidence of a long-forgotten form of ancient magic.
Ancient magic?
Yes, a powerful magic wielded by a rare few that seems to have been lost to time. Hogwarts Castle was built by and is itself a stronghold of that ancient magic. I don't know where she came into possession of the portkey, but I am certain it was to do with that search. Ah, there's the path down below. This way.
But, sir, why was your wife searching for evidence of lost magic?
Miriam wanted to understand why such powerful magic disappeared from the wizarding world. Spoke of the good it could do. But magic is no different than any power. What really matters is the one who wields it.
Is that ice?
It's not cold enough here. It appears to be a sort of enchantment. Someone wanted to block this path. Let's see some of that wand work you were practicing. Focus on the center. Excellent.
Okay, so use your camera to select an active target. Some players prefer to select targets and move the avatar with the same thumbstick by disabling camera relative to target. Gotcha. Okay, so right stick.
That was a bit rougher than I'd expected. Ah, up there. We're close now. It's just ahead. Steady yourself. Reparo.
Why would someone have built this here?
I suspect they valued their privacy. That portkey led us here for a reason. Let's have a look around for anything that seems out of place.
So, let's see where we go. Okay.
Professor, it's a mural of some kind.
Perhaps our host was a noted seer. Interesting.
Actually, do we have to go around? I think that's where I gotta go. Okay. This
way. That enchanted crystallized stone again. But what could it be blocking?
My mic came off. Should be good. Let me make sure I got that set up right.
All right, now we should be good. Cool. Okay. Oh, thanks. Yeah, my hat. It's actually, if you didn't know, that's my logo. So I don't have an online store quite yet, but at some point, maybe I'll open it back up if y'all want to buy some stuff.
What's this?
Professor Fig!
How odd. Why would someone have conjured that enchanted stone here?
And how is there a good room question. Behind it?
What room? I don't see anything.
There's that glow again, like the glow on the portkey container.
What in Merlin's name? Godric's heart.
Where are we?
I don't believe it.
Wait, okay.
Hello?
Yeah, I think you're right. I am a Hufflepuff. I did the test, and I'm pretty sure that's what it came out to be at some point. So yeah, I came out to that.
Just a moment. Where are we here? Welcome to Gringotts Wizarding Bank. Vault number 12, I presume.
Precisely.
The key?
Your wife's portkey.
Oh, yes, of course. This way, then.
Stay close.
After you. Keep your hands inside the cart if you don't wish to lose them.
How many vaults are there in Gringotts?
Hundreds. In fact, you'll see quite a few on our way to vault number 12. As we speak, we're just beneath the main lobby. The vaults you see now are the newest. Are private entrances to the bank common at Gringotts? They are most uncommon. Only one with great wealth or power, or both, could have arranged for such a service. You want to take a breath? A what? That waterfall washes away all enchantments. It's a security measure. Experienced the thief's downfall before, have you? Heard of it? These are the lower vaults that we're passing now.
How deep are we going?
Vault number 12 was commissioned shortly after Gringotts was founded over four centuries ago. It resides in the deepest part of the bank. Settle in. We've quite a distance to go.
Vault number?
Vault 12. Momentous day.
on your way.
Like the glow you saw on the porky container?
No, darker. I saw that same glow on the dragon's collar.
Yeah, what was that? We were just wondering about that goblin back there. He watches over the oldest section of the bank. Rare anyone goes there anymore. Here we are. When was the last time this vault was accessed?
A goblin has been stationed at my desk for hundreds of years. In that time, no one has visited Vault 12 until today.
Other than this game, I might go back to play, because the only other time I've streamed video games, because I used to stream on Twitch and other platforms. I used to DJ, but they would kick you off most platforms other than that. But I did stream gaming one other time when this had first come out. I was testing the stream, and it was,
I'm not sure.
So, what is it? State of Decay 2. And so I was like, okay, I'm going to go play State of Decay. And it's a great game. It's a great game for streaming. I just haven't played it that much. And so maybe when I go back and I finish this game, I'll play a little bit of that. Because that's one of those free roam games where you can kind of do stuff. But something here. And it's a little bit more interactive, because this is a good story, it seems, but I don't know if it gets to a point where it's more of an open storyline, but I guess we'll see.
Let's see what we're missing, shall we? Ready your wand and focus.
Okay, I see what I gotta do. Oh, jeez. Okay, this is kind of difficult. Oh, I see what I gotta do. I was messing that up. You gotta hit it right on its, on it. As well as moving it with the other stick, okay. Oh, it's drowning out my voice. One second. Let me see if I can turn this up just a little bit. That's a lot with the mic, so I can actually adjust my voice stuff. One second. This is nope. All right, John, now tell me if that's better. Or is it I have to be closer to the mic when I speak, too? Because it's, obviously I'm using the better mic than I used to use, but...
Revelio. There, I saw something.
Move a bit closer and try again.
A door.
Well, that's a start. There's that symbol again. I don't suppose you see a way to...
I do, Professor. That symbol has the same glow as the one I saw in the portkey container.
If what you can see reveals the way forward, then I dare say we are about to discover the secret of this
vault. Thank
you. Lead the way. Lumos! This is no ordinary vault. I suspect we will need to earn our way out of here.
What do you mean, earn our way out? Do you think this is some sort of test?
I do. But to what end, I can't say. Stay close. There will be no disapparating if things go poorly. Not out of Gringotts.
I see something up ahead.
What is it?
That glow again, but on the floor.
Lumos! What happened?
When I moved towards the glow, it suddenly seemed as if the ground was swirling about.
Are you all right?
Yes, sir, I'm fine.
You seem to have caused the floor to change.
That statue.
What statue?
I see some sort of statue, but only as a reflection in the floor.
There must be something to that reflection you're seeing. I presume this is what you saw reflected in the floor.
It is. The reflection's still there, but the statue's positions don't match. Wait. When you moved, the reflection turned in the direction of the light.
Perhaps you should cast Lumos.
Got it. I get that one now. I get it. Okay, so if I do...
Lumos.
Well done.
Now the reflection is turning towards me. It does follow the light. Revelio. Lumos.
No, I'm going in blind with this one. I've not actually seen anybody play the game, so this is my first time through. And I've not watched anybody else play, so let me see. Am I supposed to walk around? Find something else? Am I supposed to interact with the statue? Oh, there we go. Yeah, I mean, I didn't want to go in and be like, I've already seen people do this. Yeah, if it's a good, interesting storyline, I kind of want to, it's good to experience it, right, with y'all.
Confringo.
I thought that was supposed to help. Oh no. Oh, I see. I'm supposed to block their attacks, and you have to hit it as they're striking. You know, I'm not necessarily a huge Potter fan. I've been to like the Harry Potter world and stuff like that. I enjoyed the later movies. The earlier movies were... they weren't as... Oh no, I died. Try again. The earlier movies I thought were a little bit more boring, but then they got really good towards the end. So, and yeah, I enjoyed, like, I thought it was like the Wizarding World of Harry Potter at in Orlando is pretty cool. I'd definitely go back because the only one that I saw was the one at Islands of Adventure. I didn't see the one at Universal, so. Oh. Now I just gotta take them out, right? Yeah. Do we win?
Stay close.
Yes, we won. No, you're good. You're good.
Professor Fig! Professor, where are you?
This isn't good.
Uh-oh.
Where am I supposed to go? What's happening? The wisps of magic seem to be...
Yeah, I know people that live pretty close to, there actually, I know somebody that went to high school like right next to Universal, so.
Oh, that's where they're leading me. That glow again.
I used to be a bigger gamer than I am now. Me and my sister's boyfriend, or now her husband, I got stuck playing Ark with them for a very long time, like right after I separated from my ex-wife back in like 2017 or 2016. So I was playing a lot of video games then. I've kind of grew up playing video games. So I haven't played in quite a while. But yeah, I honestly, usually when I play, I'm usually playing first person shooters or I actually play a lot of like the NHL hockey games. It's funny because the last one I played though was like NHL 2017. And so I still play that one. It's fun.
I need to align these statues with their reflections.
Oh.
Lumos.
Okay.
Perhaps I need to get them all to stand at once.
Oh, wait, I didn't do this one. So where is the reflection? Right there.
Where do I need to be to get all of them to stand at once?
Probably over here. Maybe where it lines up.
I'm going to have to fight my way out of here.
Yeah, I see you just said that. Got him. Stun the enemies with stupefy counterattack. Interesting. Okay, cool. By the gold numbers. Oh, I see. I gotta hold it. Oh, jeez. Okay, I got what I gotta do. I know how to do it now. That one was okay. You have to hold the Y button down when you do the spell and then strike from there. Okay. Yeah, and then hit down arrow to heal. Interesting. All right.
Potato. Lumos.
You gotta use that shield a lot. You gotta use the shield a lot. Oh, thank you, Mishika. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Let me see, 1 second. All right, so I think I gotta light this up now, right?
Lumos.
Yes. Okay. Now we gotta find the professor. Where could he be? Oh, I see a blinking light on the. There we go. Oh. Oh, yeah. Yeah, I mean, I generally play it normal, at least first. I don't try not to take it too easy. I think I don't know. Ooh, what's this? Yes, the joint, John. We're lighting up the joint.
There you are. How did you? What is this place?
I don't know, but I found this floating above that basin.
That is no mere basin. That is a pensive for viewing memories. I wonder. Follow my lead.
Yeah, John, I still work for Free the People. I'm still the digital marketing manager there. So I love it over there. So if you haven't gone to check out Free the People's page, definitely do so.
It will only be impossible for one who cannot see traces of ancient magic as I can.
Your ability to see what others cannot will not be enough, Percival. We are entrusting the one who embarks on this path with powerful secrets, with knowledge others will do anything to obtain.
Yes, and if we are correct, Charles, the witch or wizard who completes the trials will have proven themselves worthy of that knowledge, and the responsibility that accompanies it.
We've done all that we can.
That's what you're seeing. The glow that surrounded them.
Yes, sir.
Astonishing.
Can I see magic?
Traces of an ancient magic, to be precise. The magic that Miriam had always believed existed, but could never. Miriam, and perhaps George, died in pursuit of knowledge that has been dormant for centuries. And you, it seems, are the key to understanding why. We were.
It all looks rather different than it did a moment ago.
Someone's coming.
Who were they?
I don't know. But, sir, you shouldn't be in here.
I was right. Ranrock. Seems my reputation precedes me. I was beginning to think no one was ever going to visit Rackham's Vault.
And why are you here?
No need for that. Just give me whatever it is you found here and we can let bygones be bygones.
Sir, they had the key to the vault.
Choose your next words wisely.
I only meant that the instructions to Vault 12 were quite clear. Sir, I must insist. I was to grant access only to one with the key, and you didn't have to.
I have no patience for traitors. Now, where were we?
I'm not giving you anything.
Well, perhaps your young friend here will be more helpful.
So the side quest, so like it does get into like more of an open world type stuff. That's what I kind of like that. I'm most games go open world, so yeah. Which, I mean, I have Grand Theft Auto I can play too. So I have Grand Theft Auto, I have State of Decay, I have this. So there's some games we can play.
No way out.
Are you all right?
Fine, sir.
I've never seen so powerful a goblin. He seemed wholly unaffected by my magic.
Oh, that would be so cool. I can't wait. Now I'm super excited.
It can't
Yeah,
be.
I didn't expect it to be a... Like, I guess once you get into Hogwarts, I was expecting... Most games do this, right?
Wanted someone with your ability.
Most games
to end up here.
Most games go with this whole notion of
we have a sorting ceremony to get to.
Actually, a game that I don't know if they're still doing it the same way as they used to do. I used to play a lot of one of the games I used to play like every series of was Assassin's Creed. So I love like Assassin's Creed. I love what's the other actual like assassin game I used to love playing too? So, there it is. Yes, very cool. The graphics are great on this game too. John, it's not a bad movie, it's a game. Now it's going to get into be a game now, right? I can explore and do stuff. Yeah, Assassin's Creed's fun. I used to love it when you could switch between the Animus and not. I think Assassin's Creed 3, which was like during the American Revolution, was probably my favorite. But I my brother plays a little bit, or used to play, and I think at one point they stopped doing the whole Animus stuff. So it was kind of like, why am I going to continue to play this game? There was a whole backstory with that. And then, no, what was the other Assassin's game? I used to play a lot of video games. So, like, what's another one that I used to play? Like, Fable. I used to get lost in Fable. That was one of the more early on open world games, though.
Oh, good. We haven't missed the sorting ceremony.
I've heard that too. I've heard that there's a trans character in the game.
That seems more appropriate.
Which is ironic, right?
I need to study this locket as soon as I can, but first I must contact the Ministry. They need to know what happened to George and be warned of Ranrok. For the moment, I ask that you keep all that's happened this evening between you and me.
Of course, sir.
Thank you. Ready for the sorting ceremony?
Oh, the sorting ceremony. Let's just see what we got. This should
Phineas,
be fun.
Nigellus Black. Prepare yourself to meet the headmaster.
Hitman. The Hitman games were super fun too. Those are the other games that I used to like to play.
The sorting ceremony is over.
There were
when I was in high school, we used to sit around and play. We used to do LAN parties. We used to have two Xboxes connected to play. Halo and everything. So we used to play a lot of video games. We used to play all day on Sundays. It was video game Sundays to play Halo, like the original Halo.
Professor Weasley, we've one more to be sorted.
Welcome. You're just in time. Have a seat.
What do I get?
Ah, yes. A bit older than the others, aren't you? You come here with preferences and preconceptions, certain expectations.
I can't wait to explore.
I'm looking forward to exploring Hogwarts and the world beyond the castle and grounds.
Indeed. Much can be gleaned by having an adventurous spirit. But your professors have a great deal to teach you as well. I detect something in you. A certain sense of... what is it?
Loyalty, I think. Maybe ambition. I don't know. What do you guys think? Loyalty or ambition? I'm gonna go to ambition.
Is it ambition? I may seem single-minded, but it is important to go after what you want from life.
Interesting.
Oh, no.
You recently learned that you possess a rare ability. I detect a growing sense of ambition, an eagerness for power. Perhaps you belong in Slytherin.
No! I don't see myself. I'm not hungry for power, no. I might choose a different house. No, I think I've always been. No, when I did the test, I came out as Gryffindor, honestly. So,
possess a willingness to forge ahead alone when you must.
I think I'm gonna go on Gryffindor. You say Hufflepuff though has the best the coolest unique quest, right? Go with the test results, okay. I'll do it. Alright.
I detect a growing sense of ambition, an eagerness for power.
Okay. Except House.
You belong in Slytherin!
Oh, and one more thing. Due to the unfortunate injury on the pitch in last spring's final, this year's Quidditch season has been cancelled. Enough! It's not as though I've banned flying altogether, but don't tempt me. You are here to focus on your academic futures. I'm sure you will have plenty to do before classes begin tomorrow. I said, I'm sure you all have plenty to do before classes begin tomorrow.
I am in the unforgivable.
Quite an entrance. It's lovely to meet you.
Interesting.
Professor Weasley, would you be so kind as to show our new student to their common room?
I shall see to it, sir. As I was saying, I'm Professor Weasley. Pleased to meet you.
Nice to meet you as well, Professor.
As Deputy Headmistress, it is my distinct honor to show you to your common room. Right this way. It's quite uncommon for a student to begin as a fifth year. It may be a bit of a challenge, but one I'm sure you're...
That's a good question. Where is Dumbledore?
I can be quite resourceful.
I suspected as much. This is the entrance to the Slytherin common room. In order to enter, one must simply speak the correct password. Aspiration.
Very well. Aspiration.
Oh, I see.
Well done.
Now, 100 years before Harry Potter.
You have a big day ahead of you tomorrow. I shall be back in the morning to collect you for your first class.
Thank you, Professor Weasley.
You're welcome. I hope you enjoy your first night at Hogwarts. Sleep.
There's
well.
A cute boy that wants you to learn all the unforgivables. That's funny. Oh, interesting. Interesting.
Looks like everyone's gone. Better head to the common room.
Alright. Common room this way.
I suppose some introductions are in order.
That new fifth year must be different. Starting home.
Can I help you?
I do like the music. It's nice.
You're
and...
the new fifth year. I'm Sebastian Sallow. Welcome to Slytherin.
Thank you.
Not everyone has a ministry escort to school.
He was a friend of Professor Figgs who merely joined us for the ride.
Still, impressive. Dreadful way to go, poor fellow. Glad you and Fig are all right.
It was exciting.
It was dreadful, certainly, but quite an experience nonetheless.
Interesting perspective. How did you and Fig manage to escape?
Oh, nice. It's all nice, nice. So there, we'll be playing
didn't mean
together.
To press. Right. You just get yourself settled. We can talk more later.
What book were you reading?
A spell book I picked up. Has a few interesting things, but... not exactly what I was looking for. I'm sure you'll find out soon enough. But not every spell you may need can be found in our assigned textbooks.
Oh.
Are you saying some spells aren't taught at Hogwarts? Which ones?
This is what you're talking about.
I may have met a kindred spirit. That is a conversation for another time. It was good meeting you. Good luck today.
Just real quick. There we go. It's a little bit better. Okay. Oh, yeah. Omens is the second best. Okay.
I wouldn't do that if I were you.
Wouldn't do what? I actually just started downloading Fortnite 2, but I noticed that it's optimized for Xbox XS.
Trust me.
So, I mean, I am considering getting a new Xbox. I want to say it's the Xbox X.
If you do that, you'll lose. Trust me.
We'll see. If I start playing more and start streaming more doing this, I'll definitely get a new one.
I really hope we get to see, or at least hear one today.
I think I heard one.
Doubt mermaids find us that interesting. Ah. Based on all the chatter when you entered the common room, I'm guessing you're the new fifth year. I'm Ominous. Ominous Gaunt.
Nice to meet you, Ominous.
Well, you certainly had a memorable arrival.
Well, if I'm going to make my mark here, I had to start right away.
You're definitely in the right house. Do let me know if I can be of any help as you navigate your first days here, though I doubt you'll need it.
Were you expecting to be sorted into Slytherin?
Most certainly. My family on my father's side are direct descendants of Salazar Slytherin, one of the four founders of Hogwarts. Not something I'm especially proud of.
Yeah, I guess.
Blood status.
The sassy responses would
unfortunately most
make me write as a Slytherin,
far
right?
From that tree.
Let's see.
Did that student say he thought he heard a mermaid?
Yes, but I've never heard of a mermaid showing up outside our common room window. It is fun to play along, though. Been known to keep some first years on the lookout for hours.
Thank you, Ominous. Very nice to meet you.
Pleasure was all mine. Don't be a stranger.
Oh, interesting.
If you do that, you'll lose. Trust me. Ugh, not going to move there, are you?
Here, watch this.
Don't say I didn't warn you. Checkmate. Told you. You should have listened to me. Ah, I know who you are. You're the new Slytherin, the one who barged in with Professor Fig last night. Interesting tactic on your first day, taking all the attention away from the first years. I'm Imelda, by the way. Shame I wasn't with you and Fig. I could have lured that dragon away. My skills on a broom are legendary.
We handled it, and I think you're underestimating the nature of a dragon. A broom would have been
yeah,
kidding.
She seems like a
not the way
I don't like
fly.
Her already, so
perhaps
y'all are right.
Days I'll show you a thing or two about flying. I can teach you more than Kagawa ever could. Speaking of which, I'd like to get in some time on my broom before classes.
Do you have a lot of time to fly during school?
I make the time. There's nothing like swerving through the spires of the
She's going to make me want to pull my hair out.
Are you a keen wizard chess fan? You knew that boy was going to lose the match.
Not really. Much too sedate a pastime for me. Also, it's simply not that challenging. The moves are always so obvious. Why does no one else see it?
Wow. Yeah.
Goodbye, Imelda.
Nice meeting you.
Is the new fifth year Slytherin in here? Professor Weasley's waiting for you just by the stairs.
Oh. Okay, up the stairs. Let's see.
Good morning. I trust you're ready for your first day at Hogwarts?
I've been dreaming of this day for a long time. Can't believe I'm here.
Well, you are here. Make the most of it. You only have one first day at Hogwarts. Now, in light of your unique situation, joining us as a fifth year, you'll need to catch up with your classmates and not fall behind. Especially as you'll be expected to complete your OWLs at the end of the year.
OWLs? Owls?
Yes, your ordinary wizarding level exams. They will determine what type of career you can have when you leave here. After much discussion with the headmaster and the Department of Magical Education at the Ministry, we've devised something extraordinary to ensure your success. Here you are.
What is it?
It is a wizard's field guide. It will help you to keep track of what you are learning so that you master all that's expected of a fifth year. You would be wise to take full advantage of this exceptionally valuable resource.
Thank you, Professor, but what do you mean it will keep track of what I'm learning?
Perhaps seeing it in action will answer any questions you may have. Walk with me, and we shall put it to the test.
Okay, let's go.
This way. I certainly would have appreciated something like the field guide when I was a student. Using the guide will also train you to be alert to your surroundings. The guide will give you opportunities to practice your magic and educate yourself about wizarding lore. Do keep up. Why don't you cast Revelio on that statue and see what details the field guide can provide?
Lumos.
Oh, that's true.
Revelio.
There we go. Alright, so this statue depicts the Kelpi, a shape-shifting water demon native to Ireland and Great Britain, which usually takes the form of a long-maned horse. The longest Kelpi ever reported is the Loch Ness Monster in Scotland. Interesting. Now I've unlocked a field challenge. Okay. Okay, your field tracks. My gear. Okay.
clever, isn't it?
That's a good. That's an interesting point.
Opportunities like that.
I love. Actually, let me see what else we have. What else was in here that I was missing? Handware. What did I? Do I get a special scarf? That'd be cool, right? I don't like it. It's an ugly scarf. Oh, cloaks and robes. Let's see. Wait, no, I like the robe, the cloak and robe outfit. I like that. I don't like that. Okay. I'm assuming that as you go through, you get different upgrades here, change the appearance, and then it'll help your stats and stuff, right? That's generally how things work. You upgrade your outfit and changes your stats and everything like that. No, I don't need Harry Potter glasses. Headwear. I don't have any on. Oh. No, I don't like it. Okay. Okay. We'll go back. We'll play. We'll follow Professor Weasley. What if I do that? Oh, what's this? It's all the different spells, huh? Okay. Okay. Gotcha. Yeah, I won't have y'all like sit here while I change outfits and stuff like that unless it's gonna like boost my stats. I'll do that in the off time.
Ah, good timing. Perfect opportunity to show you how to use flu flames to get around a bit quicker. Your field guide contains a map of the castle. Open it up and find Central Hall.
Central Hall. Okay, open map. Okay, divided into two main areas. The left side of the map is where students and professors live, including house common rooms and the Great Hall. Continue. So if I... Yeah, it's too slow paced for you. Well, you can watch me play. It's all good. So I guess we go to the staircase, right? Turn to map. Okay. There we go. There's the library. Let's see. Yeah, I can see this. I can see it's a good, fun, cozy game to play. It's fun. I like it so far. We'll see. I'm excited to see where it goes.
And here we are. Quite the time saver. These stairs lead directly to Central Hall. You can get almost anywhere in the castle quickly from Central Hall.
Well, thank you for joining. Yeah.
Always something happening here. It's the heart of the hive, our King's Cross Station, so to speak.
Like I said, I kind of want to start playing some playing more games, streaming more and more, and this is one way to do it in a fun way instead of just talking about politics and everything like that. So,
as soon as possible to replace the supplies you lost on the way here.
Wait.
What will I learn in charms class?
Exactly what you might expect. Spells, charms, jinxes, all terribly useful. I think you will enjoy Professor Ronan. He's a clever and entertaining wizard, and a talented teacher.
Can you tell me more about the Defense Against the Dark Arts class?
Defense Against the Dark Arts, as the name implies, focuses on how to defend oneself against the evils that lurk beyond these walls. A mastery of defense against the dark arts is required for those who aspire to become aurors. Fortunately, we are lucky to have the ever-gifted Professor Hecate in charge of our students' education in that regard.
And what is Hogsmeade?
You mentioned Hogsmeade, Professor.
Hogsmeade is the only all-wizarding village in Britain, and is home to an array of shops and pubs. You should be able to find all of the school supplies you require in Hogsmeade. You will also, I imagine, enjoy many a butterbeer there with friends in due course.
Oh, cool, cool, cool. Okay.
Thank you, Professor Weasley. A lot to absorb on your first day, and you have much to learn. Happily, your professors have agreed to create additional
assignments
outside of class. You'll be up to speed in no time.
Some of these
Judging
games
by
get
your
now.
Adept use of Revelio earlier, I'd say Professor Fig succeeded in at least showing you the basics.
He did, Professor.
He's been terribly vague as to the events preceding your arrival, specifically about what happened after that awful dragon attack. My suspicion is that there's more to the story than a search for belongings and an extended trip up to the castle.
We did take a bit of a detour on the way here. Ended up exploring some ruins and... I shouldn't say more.
Exploring ruins? Well, I presume Professor Fig has his reasons for keeping the details to himself for now. Speak of the devil. Professor Fig, your ears must have been burning.
Oh?
Yes. You seem to have provided our new fifth year with a solid foundation in the basics of spellcasting.
Ah, I'm afraid I can't take all the credit there, Professor. They've a rare aptitude for magic, it seems.
Hmm.
Yeah, I think that's kind of what's really cool about when you have open world video games that are based on movies and stuff like that. You get to explore different areas that you never would have been able to just by watching a movie and everything like that. I think that's one thing I really like about some of these, you know, open world video games.
I need to get to class myself. Might I rely on you, Professor Fig, to explain the details of the field guide's map?
Of course.
Thank you. Good luck today, and remember to use your field guide. It will be invaluable to you, and invaluable to me, as I'll be using it to keep up to date on your progress.
Yes, Professor.
Come and find me in my classroom after you've attended both classes today, and I'll explain more about those assignments I mentioned. And we'll see if we can't get you to Hogsmeade for those supplies.
It's good to see you, Professor.
And you. I was hoping our paths would cross today, before you immersed yourself in studies. Did I hear you and Professor Weasley talking about exploring ruins?
She caught me off guard. I didn't tell her anything else about our travels here. I will say, I think she suspects we're not being entirely forthcoming.
Yes, yeah. Well. About Professor to get into Weasley it. Is a brilliant and astute witch. It was right to keep the details to yourself for now. We don't know where this path we've embarked upon will lead. It may require a bit more flexibility with your time than she would approve of. And she may feel obliged to share details with the headmaster that would be better left between us.
Understood, Professor.
Good. Now, as capable as you are, I believe the ability you possess obliges you to be well-trained. Happily, you have the benefit of an exceptionally skilled team of witches and wizards to guide you. Speaking of guides, and so that I may avoid another not-so-subtle reproof from Professor Weasley, why don't I show you the clever enchantment we included in the field guide's map? Unfold it and have a look.
Okay, so that represents main quest. Lock my spell, a level requirement. Okay.
The map is enchanted to help you find your way.
This will be incredibly helpful. Thank you.
Now, it sounds like you've
that's,
quite
a day I mean, ahead. That's typical. Is they've got to teach you how to use the. They got to set the game up and then teach you to use.
He's an exceptional craftsman and a good friend.
How to do stuff, right?
When I have more information about our mysterious locket. For now, focus on your classes and
teach you how to use the controls and what buttons
do
what.
On the magic you are able to master within these walls.
Defense against dark arts. Oh, okay. So now we can start exploring a little bit, but we'll try this first one though. Interesting. Did any of y'all play the game The Division? I still love that game. God, I played that. It was that again. That was so long ago. But when it came out, it's like the 1-to-1 scale in New York City, and some of the graphics are just absolutely amazing on it. Uh, right, let's do this.
Is that all you've got? Levioso!
Professor Hecate!
Perhaps you'd be good enough to blast each other to pieces on your own time. I get new students every year, but I only have one Hebridean black skull. It was a token from the great poacher raid of 1878. No doubt you've heard of it. Now, you may be asking yourself how an old woman like me single-handedly took out the largest poacher ring in Eastern Wales and lived to boast about it.
Well, that's the thing about the Division is it is single player, unless you go into the certain zone, right? So
today we will review a spell that saved me from death at the hands of dark wizards.
The multiplayer zone,
than I care to remember.
But most of the game was played outside of the, the containment zone was played individually, and you could play it. Yeah, but it was fun. But. No, I play on Xbox, so...
One thing I've learned as an unspeakable
maybe
is the value
I doubt
of
it's even still
especially
up.
In the heat of battle. Now, let's practice what we've just learned, starting with something small.
I mean, it's, like I said, it's like probably came out in like 2017 maybe-ish, so... Alright, let's see if I can do this now. Hey, I got that one down.
Leviosa.
I think they came out with the Division 2, which was in
now,
DC.
Let's
so
try
I'd like
something
to
a little larger.
Try that one, but I think that was like a year later. Which again, I don't think many people are playing online. No, it was. It may have. You probably had to have internet connection, but it was... I mean, I think I have the... I used to get all the discs, so I had the disc of it, though.
Let us begin with the basic cost. See how the dummy deflected your cast? This time, cast Levioso first, then the basic cast. Remember, a surprised opponent is a weak opponent. As Master Pruitt so artfully helped me demonstrate earlier.
Wait.
Not well done.
Okay.
Good. Now, the basic cast. Very good. But the best way to practice is by dueling. We'll start with you two. Duelist, take your marks.
Time for a proper Hogwarts welcome.
Now, I want a fair duel, using only Levioso, basic cast, and Protego. You may begin.
Lucky.
Nothing lucky about it.
This can't be your first meal.
Bring all my students for this adept. I do need a job like this, too. Use the basic cast when your opponent's guard is down. You're good.
Now perceptive. Thank you.
Try to anticipate your opponent's next move.
I mean,
not bad for a beginner. You give as good as you get.
What's that supposed to mean?
I put you on the spot, and you rose to the challenge. Points to Slytherin.
Thank you, Professor Hecate. Glad to have the opportunity to practice.
If what I've seen today is any indication, we can expect great things from you. I demand excellence from my students. They are capable of achieving it, and they must achieve it. A classroom duel is one thing, but battling dark wizards, or as ever more likely, goblins, is a different kettle of Grindelows entirely.
Understood, Professor.
So, I'd advise you to keep practicing whenever you can.
Perhaps Mr. Sallow will have some ideas for you. Again, well done today. I shall reach out soon with additional assignments.
Interesting.
All right. That's enough speculation.
I'd hate to face Professor Hecate in a duel. Ugh.
Nice work.
I enjoyed that.
Well, that duel was quite something. Everyone will be talking about it.
It was certainly good practice.
Practice? Felt more like I was dueling an expert. Didn't expect a new student to be so deft with a wand. Then again, perhaps this wasn't your first duel.
In fact, it was. Perhaps I have a knack for it.
Be coy if you like, but I know better. Magic requires intention and talent. You know, you might be a perfect fit for a certain exclusive, unsanctioned dueling organization.
Oh. But it does sound suspicious.
Exclusive and unsanctioned. Count me in.
Excellent. Knew I was right about you. If you want to get the most out of your time at Hogwarts, you're going to need to break the rules now and then. Whether it's joining a secret dueling club or sneaking into the restricted section of the library, you just have to be clever enough not to get caught.
Thank you, Sebastian. I'll keep that in mind.
Good. Do I get an invisibility cloak?
I'm sure I'll see you soon. Perhaps somewhere unsanctioned? We'll see if your performance today was sheer luck or actual skill. Look for Luke and Brattleby near the clock tower entrance, if you're interested. Till next time.
Okay.
Huh. Always thought Leviosa was for first years. Not anymore.
Oh, she, such a bitch. Yeah, I'm on Xbox. So, I actually... So, with the Xbox and... I have an interesting setup. So I have two computers. I have my Mac, which I'm got right here, which you guys are seeing me on. That's what I'm running all the stream software off of. And then I got my PC, which is just sharing, doing the Xbox Companion app. And that's what I'm using to play the game off of. Where did I go? Okay. Alright. I mean, I've been using two computers to stream for quite a while since it's a lot of processing power for one computer to handle. So, yeah, I have a whole studio set up. I have now. I'll have to show you all pictures. I'll share it to my community because I have like a full studio set up. I've been reorganizing. Just got a new desk, got a new chair, obviously. Got everything all set up. But I've had, when I was DJing on Twitch, I needed to use a separate computer because my Mac just wasn't powerful enough to run stream software and stream fast enough. Where, I mean, now I have a brand new MacBook Air, but it doesn't have the companion app for the Xbox, which, so this works really well. Plus my PC is down here, just like down like right here. And so that's why my headphones are plugged into the PC. And I actually have so my Xbox is right sitting on top of it. And it's in, so I'm looking, when I'm actually streaming, I'm looking at a 32-inch TV, which is like right here. So I'm actually playing the Xbox off the TV, which is connected. And then my PC monitor, which is showing the exact same thing, is right here, which is what y'all are seeing on your screen. So it's a interesting setup, but it works for what I need. And then obviously my mic and camera are connected to my Mac. You know, it's not a super bad nightmare for cords. So yeah, I mean, I just have you prefer a game over a TV monitor, so, or a TV monitor over a gaming monitor, so yeah. What's interesting is, you know, the TV has two HDMI ports on the back, and so I have my Xbox running to one, I have my PC running to the other, so, like, when you see me stream on Monday nights, all I'm looking at, like, what I'm showing y'all, I have a big screen over... I'm using the TV monitor for that big screen to watch that stuff. So when you see me looking over to this side of the screen, that's what I'm looking at. I'm looking at what I'm showing you, and it's a lot easier to read. So, but this, a lot of this is new. I just started setting this up less than a month ago. So I'm excited for the, and this was kind of the goal, was to start streaming video games and playing more and all that stuff. Oh, well, thanks for joining us. I will see you later, too. And yeah.
Professor Ronan tends to go on a bit. We sometimes have to remind him to finish the lesson.
Some of us don't necessarily want him to get back to the lesson.
I managed to conjure a hedgehog once.
Actually, before I start this, I'm going to go to the bathroom real quick. So I'm going to drop off 1 second. Transfiguration.
Thank you.
I am back. Back. Very quick, see? But actually, Neowulf, if you see, like, I even got, like, the new bookshelf and everything just got here today. So I started setting that up. And just using a lot of different lighting and stuff like that. So I'm excited. I'm like, the whole setup is exactly what I want. On Rumble, I have Gabstat 2. Yeah. I don't think I need a Linux workstation. Because again, I stream off of an Xbox, or I play with an Xbox, and I'm just literally, the computer's not really doing a whole lot other than mirroring the Xbox screen, and my Mac is running the StreamYard software. So yeah, actually it's interesting because I don't even have it plugged in, Neowulf. Like, I have this new chair is nice. It's a nice gaming chair, and it has like a footrest. So I have a footrest. I actually have my speaker, which I can rest my feet on underneath. And then if I plug this in, there's this little thing like right down here, which it actually is like it vibrates. So like a little lower back massage. But yeah, so there's like, I'm literally like sitting with my, like, you can see my knees right here, and I'm just like able to kind of chill and lean back and play games, and it's a nice comfortable setup. And I can actually lean this chair back a little bit more, even like y'all get to see me like laying down. Well, most gaming chairs are comfortable, so yeah, it's a whole new setup for me. I'm happy about, you know, how it's all turned out and everything. Oh, you're not a creator, Gabstat. Well, I mean, okay, I won't follow you back. But yeah, I mean, so if you know, I'm right now I'm streaming across Twitter, Rumble, YouTube, as well as Twitch, and I'm working with the team over at Kick right now because I'm trying to get set up over there. And I'm trying to get set up over at Kick, so even my Monday streams will be playing over there too. So, oh, it's 4 a.m. Oh, I'm sorry. It's 4 a.m. on a Friday morning, or Thursday morning for you. Or no, it's Friday morning for you then. Yeah. Yeah. So if you're ever on, generally I stream politics on Mondays. So Mondays at 7 Eastern time, which I don't know what that would be your time, but yeah. But I do hope to I'm probably gonna start doing more streams like this to just play more and more, because, well, more time playing, and it's fun. And like I said, like I was talking about earlier, I haven't really played video games in quite some time, but at that same time, if I'm playing, why not stream it for the most part? So I'll be here with y'all most of the time that I'm streaming, so it'll be fun. And yeah. Let me see. Oh, you have a gaming channel too? On what platform? On Kick or Twitch? Let me see. I mean, I won't lie, like, Twitter's probably got the best viewership so far on here. So it is, it's fun. Let me see. Yeah. definitely. The thing about I do really, again, if you're new to the channel, you know that I will call it Twitter until they give me subscriptions, and then and then we'll do that. But the thing is it still seems so far, because I have to build my Twitch following back up, because I had a pretty good following when I was DJing on Twitch, but I haven't done that in since what, 2020, maybe 2021 ish. I stopped DJing, stopped doing a lot of other stuff, and focused on political content. And so now we're just kind of expanding and just doing whatever I want. But what I notice is, even still, like, y'all over at YouTube are still the best, still the most active when it comes to comments. So it's hard. Anytime I'm live, it makes sense to go live on YouTube. Welcome back, Valerie.
My cousin was transfigured into a mouse by an older bully last year. Took hours to get her to come out from under the bed.
I was worried transfiguration would be too difficult, but it turns out I have a knack for switching spells. Mother says it's my indecisive nature. Hogwarts has brought me and my siblings closer together. We've had to rely on each other without going off.
Stu, was this charm school?
Here, behind you, there is an open seat here.
Thank you.
Hello, I am Nettie. So you are the new student. Have you met Professor Ronan yet?
Shall we begin? Welcome to year 5 of charms. Now, this will be a crucial year in your education on the art of charm work, but I am confident that we will take hold with the passion and rigor requisite of such a challenge. Right, now, everyone, please open your textbooks to page 517. But before we begin, can anyone here tell me the difference between the incantations of the color change and growth charms? Anyone? Hmm? I am afraid it is too late to study now. My, the summer months must have really taken a toll on you all. By the looks of it, you all spent your holidays practicing Obliviate on one another. Do you even remember how to perform a basic summoning charm? Well, it seems that we are in dire need of review. Everyone get into pairs and take positions on opposite sides of the classroom. Now let's put those textbooks to use as the blunt objects you so believe they are, and take turns summoning them out of one another's hands. Only one book will be needed per partnership, Miss Dale. Thank you. Get into place now.
Oh, here we go again. Let's see. Hey. Got it.
Akio! That is not bad.
You are a swift learner. I see a lot of potential, but remember, potential is nothing without practice. Keep at it. You might just rival Miss Onai here. Very good, everyone. That's enough of that. Well, as you all seem to have the basics down, and it is an exceptionally lovely day, I was thinking
a lot
that we might have ourselves a little excursion outside for a spot of fresh air.
It seems like an interesting, a good spell, right? Pull stuff.
I've always found that fun goes hand in hand with mastery, as I'm sure the Quidditch players amongst us would agree. So, what better than a bit of sport to put our prowess with the summoning charm to the test, right? So why don't we have our newest student start us off? Very simply, cast Accio on one of the spheres and relinquish your charm. That's it!
Oh, I see. I stop it. Sure. Okay.
It's like gobstones, if you will. But instead of throwing the marbles out, you are splendid! Excellent control there.
Come on, stop. Got it.
Very good. Points to Slytherin. But there's certainly no sport in playing without some friendly competition. Miss Onai, would you care to give our new student a bit of a challenge? Come on up. You'll be the blues, just as before, and Miss Onai, you are playing red. Clear?
Yes, sir.
So there's an unofficial Rumble creators page. I'll ask so I have friends that work over at Rumble, so I'll talk to them about joining there and stuff. Yeah. That's actually, I have, what is it, one point something thousand followers over on Rumble. I've had a couple of videos that have done tens of thousands because it's been pretty good.
Very good.
Here we go.
So I'll talk to my friends and see about doing more gaming streams on Rumble and see what they can do to help me over there and see. Stop! Oh man!
Don't lose your composure. Let us see this.
Yeah, I mean, so Valerie, I use Rumble. I like when I stream across platforms on Rumble. I stream on Rumble. Everything I stream on YouTube is on Rumble. It's also on Twitter and planning on going everything on Kick at least, and then using Twitch at least for gaming. So
brilliant.
Yeah, but they won. I lost this one.
Let us make this.
No, I actually use StreamYard. So that's what I was kind of explaining earlier. I have two computers set up and I use everything on StreamYard to to stream everything across platforms. So like when I'm looking at the screen right now, I can see exactly what I'm streaming, like where my StreamYard allows you now to customize screens, so it's not the same. So it's like I can use StreamYard the same way as pretty much using OBS with Restream, and it's a lot easier. Yes.
That was an execution.
StreamYard. So StreamYard. Yeah. It's you have to pay for it if you want more of the stuff on it, but it's, for me, it's completely worth it.
That's it!
Let us see this. That is how it's done.
Actually, I don't have to do anything.
Stay focused.
It doesn't matter. I won. Yeah, I'm still here. I went to the bathroom real quick.
Well done.
But I'm still here. I'm still playing. You weren't gone for very long either. I don't know. RIC, what is it? I don't know who you're talking about. No, I guess I
just gathered your things on the way out.
Good game back there. I must admit, I think I underestimated you. Took me weeks to become proficient with Akio.
But
weeks for me to get anything right.
So the good thing though about StreamYard is I have, you can tell there's the chats. So Twitch, YouTube, and Twitter, the chat, like the whole chat, I can see the chats from all platforms on a StreamYard. Rumble's a little bit different. You have to use the stream key. Same with Kick. So you have to, I have two different chats over here on another screen over here. So if you didn't know, I actually have four screens on my desk. And then I don't use my iPad very much, but it's set up ready to go too. It's a lot of screens. Somebody's like, you need more screens. I was like, it's a lot of screens. And so I pulled out, I have another MacBook that I could use if I wanted to. Well, Streamlabs is it's basically a version of OBS, right? You do Restream and StreamYard. It allows you to stream across multiple platforms, and I don't know if Streamlabs OBS is the same way, but I mean, I've used OBS since I started doing content and streaming. It's good. OBS is great even just for recording videos. So I do like it, and it's very customizable, obviously. Okay.
Thank you, but I've been holding my own. I appreciate your confidence. I transferred here from Ouagadougou just before my fourth year. My mother received an offer to teach divination here. Before I knew it, we had left Uganda and were halfway around the world at a new school in a new country. This may seem an odd question, but is magic the same there as it is here?
Mostly, yes. But I did have to learn how to use a wand when I arrived here. Hardly anyone at Ouagadougou uses one.
Oh man, that's a kind of a... Surely the magic is weaker? Oof. No, that's...
You can cast spells without a wand.
Oh yes. I find wandless magic to be much more instinctive. Not to mention quite convenient if one is without their wand. I must admit, however, that I am growing quite fond of using a wand. It seems very dramatic.
Is Ouagadougou much bigger than Hogwarts?
Ouagadougou School of Magic is the largest wizarding school in the world. So yes, bigger than Hogwarts. But it never seemed intimidating or overwhelming to me. It always felt like home.
It's nice to learn about another wizarding school.
Thank you for asking. I do miss Wagadu, but I am glad to be here at Hogwarts. Ah, I think Professor Ronan wants to talk to you. Better not keep him waiting. Until next time.
No, I don't know. I don't know Rick. I know Siraj over at Rumble. If you're so the Habibi inclined. Bro Siraj over there. So that's who I know.
Be precise, Bastion. You know it won't work on humans.
A word, if you would.
You wanted to speak with me, Professor?
I did. I trust your first charms lesson lived up to expectation?
Well, an outdoor competition.
Well, thank you.
Exactly,
I do appreciate you sending me over here.
What
yeah.
Charm is there in the expected?
Thank you.
You did
thank
well
you.
Managing to best as gifted a student as Miss Onai.
I'm in Slytherin.
I enjoyed the match.
Miss Onai.
Which is interesting because when I took the test before, it put me in
she is a bit distracted
Gryffindor, but. The no, actual my
Weasley
actual
has asked that your professors give you instruction
house is Gryffindor, but this put me in Slytherin, so
expect to hear from me
we'll
soon.
See it. It'll be fun.
A special assignment that I am preparing for you.
Is there something over here that I can go into?
Hello there. You're the new student, aren't you?
Yes, I am.
Hello. You wanted to speak to me.
Samantha Dale. I've been eager to meet you. You're the student everyone's been whispering about.
Oh.
Hope your first day's going well. You certainly seem to hold your own in charms.
I've been fortunate. Beginner's luck.
My brother William would tell you not to be so humble and to trust your abilities. Then again, he tends to be overconfident in his. Well, better see to my charms homework. I'm afraid I can't count on beginner's luck to impress Professor Ronan.
What's this?
Transfiguration requires such precision. And by the way, the Minister for Magic was Albert Boone. It was Albert Boot.
No, it wasn't. It was Basil Flat.
Ooh, fight! It's a bold attack! Was the Minister a Boot or the Minister a Flack?
Stop it, Peeves! You'll get us in trouble!
In trouble you will be, but you can't give Peeves a smack! She says it's a Boot, and he says it's a Flack!
Peeves! Enough! You'll get us
what's
all
that?
Attention! And you're both wrong anyway. It was Hephaestus Gore.
It wasn't Boots and it wasn't Flack, but you're all in trouble with Professor Black.
Yeah, I should. Maybe I will. Maybe I'll. We'll take the test right here on stream. I could definitely show that. I have to look back where it was. I don't remember. It was actually, I took the test because my friend Ariel Scarsella asked me which house I was in. I forget what house, I think she said she's a Hufflepuff, but I think I had taken it because she had asked me, and it was Gryffindor, but that's exactly what she had put me into, so... You know, I am not the best at doing math, like, in my head, but Let me see, the animals are 0 through 9. They have to add up to the number in the middle. There's no, Ariel's not. Ariel's this super sweetheart. She's not Slytherin. Gryffindor maybe. But she is very much, if you know astrology, very much a Cancer in astrology. So, and if you know me, I'm very much a Libra. So, which actually ties quite a bit into like your house in. Like astrology seems to tie quite a bit into the house that you fall into in these situations, because it obviously helps, it shows, it generally helps with like your personality types and everything like that. So yeah, I can't open it though. How do you? Oh, see, I don't know what all the signs are. And it's funny because Ariel can tell you exactly what your sign is, like just by meeting you. She would be like, well, you're this. I've literally seen her do this multiple times. And it's like, she can tell you what your sign is. And it's like, oh my gosh, how do you know? And so, I'm not that good with astrology, but I can tell you that. So I'm a Libra sun, a Taurus moon, and a Sagittarius rising, and everything with astrology, it fits pretty much perfectly. Like when I tell people that, they're like, "Yeah, it's exactly what you would expect." Wait, what's this? Oh, I see. Is that not you're supposed to do it? Oh, wait, what's this? Wait, what is this? I don't get it. Okay, well, that's not helpful. I don't get it. No, yeah, 0 plus 3. Plus question mark equals 5. Yeah, that, I mean, that would be, that's 3 minus 5, right? So 2? So it's a 2, but I don't. Oh, it's algebra. I actually am pretty good at algebra. Algebra is like the top one that I'm good at, right? And actually, so 2 question marks would equal, I just don't understand where. Wait. Do these things have anything to do with each other? Okay, so that is 0. So if that, like, what is that, like a muskrat or something at the bottom? So the unicorn would, what, be 1? The unicorn's 1? Okay. So if that, okay, so then that is, okay. That would be it. That's what I'm looking for. But why isn't it opening? Oh, there's another one you said. Oh, I see. So then 4 plus 1 equals 12. So 5 minus 12. So 7, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So it's the lizard? Well, it can't be the lizard. Yes, I'm the man. It's the legs guy. Oh, did I? Okay. Actually, one more. That one. Okay, let's see. No. That one. Hey. Oh, I got a footstool. I got a scholar's robe. Interesting. Let's see what that looks like. Robes. Go to the scholar's robe. Does it actually, let me see. Oh, it actually helps with my offense. Nice. Integrity's in the chest. Okay. Now, let's see. Fun. Okay, so tell me, when do we get to fight Voldemort? Interesting. Oh, baby Dumbledore. Okay. And y'all said this castle's way too big and way too detailed. Let me see. Get out of my way.
Oh, do shut up.
Suppose, are you curious about a beautification potion?
What? Not for me, never mind. For a friend of mine. Don't be stupid.
Oh, everything.
All right, Let's see. Oh, wrong one. So what we're gonna do, we're gonna go to the next quest. The Transfiguration classroom. That sounds like my type of classroom. Yes. Actually, what's in the globe? I love like the detailed like we were talking about this a little bit earlier. I think you might have been gone, but it's like the details on some of these new games is amazing. Let's see.
Don't get too cocky simply because you had one victory over Salad.
Have y'all ever been to the, it makes you sick. Have you been to, on the Wizard, the Harry Potter ride at, Universal, where it's like you, like go, like you're flying through Hogwarts? It's like super cool.
Never forget what that Hufflepuff girl said in 1421. What lovely stone. Oh, that's class, that is. In trouble, are we? Paid up to that
good. Wrong way. Where am I going? I gotta go this way. Oh, courtyard. Yeah, it can. It can cause some... Well, and actually, yeah, I know people who were afraid of heights that when we wrote it, they were like, I didn't really like it very much. And it was partially because of the nausea, like the motion, as well as the perceived heights that you're at was scary. But it was interesting. I used to be afraid of heights. I'm not so much anymore. But a lot of that came from being in the army and doing like rappelling and stuff and jumping out of airplanes and all that while I was there.
What about the room, Professor?
I was thinking the same thing, Deke. Perhaps you could help.
Mm.
Oh, excuse, Deke.
Ah, there you are.
I trust your first classes went well?
They did, Professor.
I heard as much from Professors Hecate and Ronan. Seems Professor Fig taught you quite a bit during your brief detour near... What was it you said? Some ruins? I'd wager there's a good deal more to your travels here than what you've told me. Isn't there?
One second.
Have you and Professor Fig not discussed my training?
He continues to be reticent about the details, mentioning only a few spells. Revelio, was it? And Lumos?
That's correct, Professor.
I see. Like trying to get a sonnet from a Strela. Regardless, you must continue to build upon what you've learned. In that regard, I've asked your professors to help hasten your progress with some extra assignments.
Okay.
I'm not sure I have time for extra assignments, Professor.
You shall find the time. You'd be astonished to know just how much.
I'm not sure how much longer I'll play. Play for
Professor Ronan will maybe meet you
maybe 30 minutes more
to assign your first one. Now, regarding the trip to Hogsmeade I mentioned earlier, we've arranged to replace the supplies lost on your way here, including seeds, potion recipes, and spellcrafts.
Thank you, Professor.
And Mr. Ollivander will connect you with the perfect wand. You've managed your classes well with a borrowed wand, but you'll find the magic you cast with your own wand to be far superior.
Can you tell me more about the potion shop, Professor?
J. Pippin's Potions stocks a wide array of potions ingredients, although they rarely sell recipes. Professor Sharp asked that they have a couple of particular recipes on hand for you.
I've never heard of a spellcraft before, Professor. What is it?
A spellcraft is a recipe of sorts used when conjuring objects. I shall explain more about them when you begin working with transfiguration magic.
There's an Ollivander's in Hogsmeade.
There is. Most people are familiar with the shop in Diagon Alley. We're fortunate to have someone like him nearby. Mr. Ollivander is a genuine craftsman and highly skilled wand maker. I would trust no one else to pair me with a wand.
Well, thank you. I always try to get my characters to look like me. So yeah.
I'm eager to get to Hogsmeade.
Very well. I'd like you to make your first visit to the village with a classmate. Help you get your bearings. Perhaps Sebastian Sallow or Natsai Oni. I've noticed you spending time with
them. Well, thank you, Poop Loop. I definitely try. Oh, no. No. It is interesting because I used to have, I mean, obviously when I was growing my hair out, at one point it was about that same length and it was just very blonde when it was at that length. Who should I go with?
I'd like to go with Sebastian.
Glad to hear it. Mr. Sallow is a capable young wizard, and he knows the area. He'll keep you well clear of any of Victor Rookwood's undesirables en route.
Rookwood?
A rather unsavory local. Best to avoid him and his associates, including his right hand of sorts, Theophilus Harlow, if you can. Once you've finished Professor Ronan's assignment, your friend will meet you at the castle doors. No time to waste. The sooner you complete your work, the sooner you can enjoy a butterbeer at the Three Broomsticks.
Get some butterbeer. Do you get drunk off butterbeer? Okay. I'm glad I picked Sebastian right before you said it. Where am I going?
How nice to see you, my young friend.
I enjoy having lunch down by the lake.
Ah, there you are.
You have a new spell to teach me, Professor?
Indeed I do, and an exceedingly useful one at that, the mending charm, Reparo. Fixes things right up, makes a broken object good as new in the blink of an eye.
It seems as if that might come in handy.
More frequently than one would imagine. As Professor Weasley mentioned, I am not the only one who will be teaching you spells outside of class in an effort to catch you up with your peers. A number of your professors have agreed to do so as well, but first, each shall ask that you complete a few preliminary tasks to hone your magic. I have arranged some for today. See them through and then report back to me. We will have you casting Reparo in no time.
Why must I first complete tasks to learn Reparo?
No lesson or lecture can compare to first-hand experience. And these tasks should provide you with just that. Such experience is invaluable when mastering any new bit of magic.
I'll start on the task right away, Professor. This is the right area. I wonder where the flying page is.
Oh.
Got it.
Got it.
Thank you.
trust the preliminary tasks weren't too much trouble.
I completed the assignments, Professor.
Marvelous. You clearly know your way around basic charms. Let us give the old mending charm a try then, shall we? Remember to be deliberate in your enunciation and movements. I want to see some vigor. Now, wand at the ready.
Yes, sir.
Remember, your wand is a conduit of your magic.
Get there.
That was difficult. Actually, what's now a mending? That's okay, so reparo is now okay.
That's it. Very good.
Reparo.
If you would like to practice mending something, have a go with that broken statue in the alcove by the water. It allegedly symbolized heartbreak. Perhaps a jilted lover thought it too accurate and lashed out.
Okay, cool. Where do I go to Hogsmeade now? Where? What do I gotta do? I gotta go to the main storyline? Okay. That's where we're gonna go. We're gonna go to the main storyline. We're gonna roll with that. Well, welcome. Yes, a gaming stream.
This cannot possibly be as difficult as it seems.
I've never played Cyberpunk, no. Like I was kind of telling everybody earlier a little bit. It's been a while since I played a lot of video games, and I was going to play this when it first came out, but I only have an Xbox One, so it took forever for it to come out, and I just hadn't really played video games in a while. And then,
well, fancy meeting you here.
And then I was like, "Hey, I should play," and that's kind of why I'm playing tonight. And then, but the other game that I had streamed before when doing a test stream was
foray into the village,
State of Decay 2, which really seems like a cool game. It is a cool game to play.
It's a charming little place.
And it's self-contained. Obviously, a wide open.
Be able to find you everything that you need.
It's a wide open base platform where you're trying to build your, you know, community, like the after the apocalypse. So, I think it's a fun game. So I haven't played, I actually am still very early on. I haven't played too much. I haven't built too much up in it. So I think I'm going to play this game until I beat it. And then what we'll do is I'll just jump back into State of Decay, play that for a little while, maybe play that intermittently here and there. But it is cool to kind of build your zombie apocalypse community and everything like that up. It's a fun game. But at some point, I'll probably get the new Xbox if I'm streaming and doing stuff more, so I can get more and better games. But that just depends on obviously if y'all like me playing more games and being on here, and that's kind of where we're at, but I'll probably play more. I'll probably be streaming more. When I'm home, I'll probably stream. I don't know if I'll have a set schedule because
I was glad, Professor Weasley.
It's hard to have a set schedule and a life.
Thank you, by the way.
Of course. You're the only one who's ever bested me in a duel. The way I see it, I'd be wise to keep
You gotta keep everybody from dying, and then you have to go out, and then you have to like not die yourself when you go out. It's a very stressful game.
Speaking of Weasley, she seems to have taken quite a shine to you.
Has she? That's nice to hear.
I'm still surprised that a professor would entrust me with anything, given my detention record.
Spend a lot of time in detention, do you?
Just enough to keep me well-rounded. Speaking of detention, this trip to Hogsmeade might have saved me from one.
Glad I could be of service.
Madam Scribner, the librarian, was on the hunt for me, as is often the case. Professor Weasley came to retrieve me, and I was able to convince old Scribner that I had somewhere to be.
So how did you manage to get on the librarian's bad side?
Well, I suspect it's a matter of differing opinions. She thinks I shouldn't be allowed in the restricted section, and I, on the other hand, am inclined to disagree. Oh, just one moment. This is an excellent spot to gather lacewing flies. They're pretty to look at. If you stew them long enough, they make a powerful potion ingredient. Merlin's beard from the Forbidden Forest. Look!
What's going on?
See for yourself. Quite a sight, isn't it? You certainly don't see that every day.
Do you think Poppy's already seen the hippogriffs?
But yeah, actually, absolutely. Like, if you heard what I was talking about earlier, I had played Ark.
To the left is the
if you've never
forest.
Played Ark, Ark is a fan. It's a phenomenal game, but you have to be very invested in it and invested in it with your friends for the most part.
I think we need to have more confidence in our defensive abilities.
It can take a long time to get up and even running on that game. And it takes a long time, but at some points you can actually start to.
Have you had much of a chance to explore?
Train dinosaurs, but that part of that is even just keeping your dinosaurs and you.
It is that. I've been 5 years and barely scratched the surface.
Was places to alive?
Oh, any
let alone building a community and stuff like that. But if you're part of a good team,
you still haven't told me how
you don't necessarily need to do it, but you kind of have to be addicted to it. I just didn't have the time to do it.
I've always
Ark is fun. Ark, right?
Though I suppose most people.
Yeah, I think. Yeah, exactly. You're.
Unfortunately,
I've tried to play the solo mode.
Most notably,
and I was playing with my sister and now brother-in-law at the time, and they had like a huge community, so I never really worried about dying and stuff like that. We used to actually do like boss fights and everything. I always say Ark is actually more like Minecraft and Jurassic Park kind of mixed.
Hello, Mr. Moon. Have you met our new fifth year?
Pleasure. You might want to turn back, Mr. Sallow. Turn and run.
Is everything all right, sir?
Oh, look right at me.
Oh, you said Power World. World is like Ark meets Pokemon. Interesting.
Demi guys.
We used to like breed Gigas. We used to breed T-Rexes. We had everything. We used to do like multi server raids and stuff like that. It was a fun game. If you had people that
never seen Mr. Moon,
I could never spend the time that the people that I was playing with could spend on it, but I was able to jump in on weekends and some nights and play with them. And
I'd say he could improve a bit as a
Your sister.
I mean, it was fun, but it was. You had to be very engaged all the time and be very addicted to it.
Honestly, if one could bottle the magic of this place, I don't know if it's the shops or the people, but there's just something about Hogsmeade. We all flock to it like moths to a flame.
Yeah, exactly. So that's why the solo companion or even PvE was pretty.
So how would you like to do this? Weasley told me you had a list of things to get. A wand and
yeah, PvE was pretty popular too.
Spellcrafts and some potion recipes.
Perfect. Can't wait to see what you do with the new wand. And a short list gives you plenty of time to poke around the village. I just have to pop into a shop to find something for my sister. Let's meet up in the town circle when you're finished. Remember, have fun. It's Hogsmeade.
Okay, so I'm going here to get my wand. Okay. Cool.
I'll be right with... Ah, it's you. Just a moment, please.
Hello, sir. I'm looking for...
For a new wand, yes. It's about time.
Yes, I... About time.
Well, you're our new fifth-year student, are you not? Oh, what am I saying? Of course you are. Gerbold Ollivander's the name. But of course, you'll have heard of the Ollivanders, I'm sure. Finest wand makers in the world. It's a pleasure to meet you, truly. Now, come with me. Let's find you the perfect wand, shall
yes,
we?
Yes, let's get the perfect wand. Let's go.
No, not you. Yes. Yes. Powerful core. 10.5 inches. You might do. Here, give this one a try. Well, go ahead, swish. How odd. Once more, come on, really swish it. Oh dear. Well, this isn't a good match at all, is it? We'll find you something, not to worry. No, not you. Perhaps. Yes. A rare wood, 13¾ inches, dragon heart string. Let's give this one a try. Oh, goodness. Looks like it's back to the shelf for you. This is proving to be trickier than I had anticipated. How perplexing. Where are you? Perhaps you? There you are. Yes. I think you might be the one. Here. Take it.
Curious indeed. How intriguing. Curious indeed.
I like that one.
How intriguing. Curious indeed. How intriguing. Curious indeed. Intriguing.
Good cherry. Good cherry wood. Okay. Interesting, interesting. Yeah.
Curious indeed.
Nah, I'm a good. Nah, cherry wood. Let's see. Now, what do we got?
How intriguing.
No. 10¾ inches. Yes. I don't think I've done a video about J.K. Rowling in probably close to a year. The thing is, I've actually tried to get J.K. Rowling to just notice me on Twitter, right? Like, and possibly sit. I would love to sit down and have a conversation with J.K. Rowling because I think it would be a very good and powerful conversation that we could have. But I support J.K. Rowling in so many ways, and so I just like everybody just needs to let Yeah, I would love to have a conversation. I think it would be something that could be beneficial for society. But I don't know if I've ever been able to catch her eye at this point. I know people that she follows other trans people that I know. So maybe someday we could have a good conversation, sit down and do one of my old interviews in that. I think it would be phenomenal. I think that would be something that could be like, it could benefit a lot of people. It could benefit and kind of bridge the divide as to what's happening. Because even when I said I was going to do this stream today you know, supporting J.K. Rowling, somebody said on Twitter, was like, was putting, I think it was somebody that even maybe even followed me, was putting out some of the same stuff that they, you know, the activists and stuff put out about her. But when you actually listen to her in her own words, or read her own words, and you see the context behind everything she's saying, I don't think at all that she's what these activists have tried to paint her as. I mean, maybe we'll see. I mean, if people go into her chat and are like, "Hey, you should talk to Sarah Higdon. You should talk to Sarah Higdon," maybe it'll help too. I think it would be an amazing conversation, and we could see, like, try to get some. Yeah, we could get some sort of compromise on some things and just see, like, maybe start to bridge the divide. And that's always my goal, is bridging the divide. Let's see. Solid. We're gonna go solid. All right, that is, let me see. Oh, I would say the Phoenix Feather. Yeah, let's go with the Phoenix.
Ah, Phoenix Feather. Exceptionally rare, and a core with a strong sense of initiative. What do you think?
I'm sure it's just for fun.
Another wand, another beginning of a bright and magical future. Now, how did that feel?
Good. Different. I sensed a sort of surge of some kind.
A match. Your connection seemed particularly powerful. The right wand will learn from you, just as you learn from it.
I'm eager to try it out.
Of course. And a Phoenix Feather core is terribly selective. This will be an excellent match indeed. And the bond between you and your wand should only grow stronger. Do not be surprised at your new wand's ability to perceive your intentions, particularly in a moment of need.
That sounds wonderful, Mr. Ollivander.
I'll let you get to it. Do come and see me again if ever I can be of further assistance.
All right, let's what's this? A chest. Got a new school uniform. Let's see what this looks like. Okay. Let's see, where do we go now? What's in here? Oh, it's locked. All right, let's see. Where do I gotta go? Oh, it's a... That's... Okay, so that's a broom shop. So I gotta go there when I get the ability to go to... To fly.
Welcome to J. Pippin's Potions.
Pardon me, sir.
Oh, thank goodness. When I heard the bell, I thought you were Miss Lawang. Not that she deigns to come here. Though, I don't believe I've seen your face here before, either.
It's my first time in Hogsmeade, actually.
Is it really? Well, Parry Pippin at your service. And this is J. Pippin's Potions. Potions for all ailments. You'll have read it on the sign, of course, but Grandfather always made me say it in full. How may I help you today?
Professor Weasley sent me to collect some recipes. I'm new at Hogwarts.
You're the student she sent the owl about. I set your things aside immediately. I suspected if you're anything like I was at your age, you'd want your potion supplies. Is it not the most fascinating art, potion making? Rivals anything you can do with a wand, I've always said.
Are potions really that versatile?
They may not be as showy as spellwork, but make no mistake, they are just as powerful. They can heal, destroy, protect. You'll discover all of this soon enough. As it's your first time in, I should mention that it's not just potion recipes I sell. I also offer ready-made drafts for all manner of uses, and I unveil new ones from time to time. Pop in when you can so you don't miss out on anything. But for now, let's get you those recipes, shall we?
$2,000 or $2,500 for the first broom. Okay, okay. I don't know what you mean there, but okay.
Feel free to take a look at the rest of my inventory, or come back another time if you're in a rush today.
Let's see. Oh, okay. So basically, save up as much as possible because I have like $85 right now for that. And so, okay. Okay. Gotcha, gotcha, gotcha. Let's see. Now, let's go. Oh, what's this? Ooh, I got a sorcerer's hat. Let's see. Okay, so sell old stuff sometimes. Cool. Hat. Defense. But it's an ugly hat. What are they doing? I guess I'll wear it. Yeah, I gotcha. So, anything that's of value that you can sell that, yeah. Again, that's kind of like the Assassin's Creed model. You know, you go and you upgrade your outfit and then you sell what you don't need type stuff, yeah. All right. Where are we going? Hmm. Actually, where am I? Okay. Where the magic meet then? Okay, so y'all love the hat. Okay. 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 I'm going to finish up with the Hogsmeade stuff and then I'll probably be done for the night. So let's see what we got. And the pink ciders one are adorable. Okay. Wait, so what do you mean you can transmag your outfit? What does that mean?
Well, hello there.
Pardon me, sir. I'm here for the seeds Professor Weasley arranged for me to collect.
Ah, the dittany for the new fifth year. I take it that's you, then. Merlin's beard. Starting Hogwarts is a fifth year. You must be positively reeling from it all.
Not at all. I'm choosing to see it all as one big adventure.
Well, bravo. Not everyone has the temperament to take things as they
come. Oh, I see.
Name's Timothy Teasdale, by the way. And this is my shop.
I see.
The Magic Neat.
That makes sense.
I keep the cart out here because I'm...
But y'all love the hat, so I'll keep it.
Can't very well be in the thick of things if I'm hidden away inside now, can I?
I suppose not.
In addition to seeds, I have plenty of plants. Grow everything myself. My speciality is potion ingredients. Even Pippin purchases from me. But what say we get you a packet of Dittany seeds? Do have a look around. Plenty of ingredients to pique your interest, I'd wager.
Alright. Tomes and Scrolls. No, I mean, okay. It's cute. It's cute. It just doesn't go with the cloak that I'm wearing. And so, you know, like, it needs to all match. It didn't look cute, but until I put it on, okay. I get it. I see something that I can actually grab. Uh-oh. Uh-oh. Thank you. Got it.
Let me answer. Prepare.
Okay. Yeah, I got it. I don't know what it is, though. It'll be okay. Let's go. Bum, 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 bum. Oh, I see.
An inquiring mind.
Pardon me, sir. I'm here for the spellcrafts Professor Weasley ordered.
Matilda's student. I thought I might be seeing you soon. I am the proprietor here, Thomas Brown. I take it you've had a conjuring lesson then?
I'm afraid I haven't yet, sir.
Ah, but you will soon enough. It is magic at its purest, creating something out of nothing.
Oh, so you can use Revealo. Okay. Complexity. Makes sense.
But that is where my spellcrafts come in. Stay the course. And you could soon impress even Professor Weasley.
That's certainly something to aspire to, Mr. Brown. I look forward to that day.
And I, too, seeing it. Spellcrafts are incredibly useful for conjuring unique items like custom pieces of furniture or decoration. But I shall let Professor Weasley do the teaching. For now, let's get the spellcrafts you need. A potting table and a potion station. Yes?
I believe so, sir.
Good. Nothing like being able to grow your own ingredients and brew what you want, when you want. Let's have a look. If you're interested, feel free to take a look around at the rest of my inventory.
Well, that's everything. Better go and find Sebastian.
It's a kitty. Okay.
I officially have all of my supplies.
You have to stop and pet the cat. You have to.
So I suppose the world is our oyster now. Let's see what else we can get up to.
What? Draw it away.
away from the building! Away from the village!
I mean, it's a nice touch, just some simplistic touch, you know. It's nice, you get to pet some cats and stuff.
And Gringo.
Are we weakening him at all?
Keep at it. We'll wear him down eventually.
Oh, I can't levitate him. Okay, cool. Oh, jeez.
What was that?
He brings a taste of his own medicine.
Nicely done.
Why, I am getting beat up.
Confringo.
Beat a dodge. He's too thick to be done with much else. What am I missing? I'm missing it's X, right? Is to block. Hit RB on the screen. Okay. Oh. Okay. So I have to roll, which is the RB. Okay. Now let's kick some troll butt. Okay. Okay, so throw B, okay.
I officially have all of my supplies.
Excellent.
Did you get what you needed for your sister?
I did. So I suppose the world is our oyster now. Let's see what else we can get up to.
Oh, I rolled right into it.
Nice to be done.
blubbering louse.
He's holding.
Two more hits should do the job. Stringer.
Goodness, a second troll. Did you two take on a fully grown troll by yourselves?
I suppose so. It's all a bit of a blur, to be honest.
Merlin's beard. Are you all right?
We are, and we were glad to help.
I'd say help is a bit of an understatement. Nerve like that. The makings of an aura, if you ask me. If you are unharmed, perhaps the two of you wouldn't mind helping me put a few things back to where they were.
Of course, Officer.
Singer. Officer Singer. And thank you, again.
Oh, hello there. A moment, if you would.
I'll go and see what she wants.
Lucky they didn't even know. Thing for Officer Singer to worry about.
Repairer. Repairer. Ah, good to see you. Yes.
Yeah, I mean, Reparo would be pretty interesting to have in real life, right? Break something, just use a spell. The detail there, that's pretty good.
Mr. Hill was just singing your praises.
Hello, sir. I don't believe we've met.
Allow me to introduce myself, Augustus Hill, clothier extraordinaire. I should like to thank you for your remarkable bravery in fighting those trolls, and not to mention your help restoring Hogsmeade to its rightful state.
I was happy to help.
Frankly, you deserve an Order of Merlin. But I can offer you something much more useful. I own Gladrag's Wizardware, and among my inventory are some unique items that afford certain protections, as it were. Life-saving protections. And as I suspect this won't be your last dangerous encounter, I'd like to give you one such set of robes, in thanks for what you did today.
Thank you, Mr. Hill. That's very generous of you.
It's the least I can do. Now, let's try this on for size, shall we?
Oh. Okay, so it's...
I'd say that looks as if it was made for you.
So the superb scholar's robe is actually less. Is actually less valuable than this one that they just gave me. Wait, oh, so green's higher level than blue? So, but this one can be upgraded. So it's a higher value of offense, but it's... But I wouldn't want to get rid of the blue one. Okay. Interesting. Yeah, so like right now, I wouldn't want to get rid of the blue one because it could be upgraded at some point. Gotcha. I gotcha. So I'll end up finding more. Interesting. Makes sense. And then you get the purples and all that. Okay.
I suspect you have a sharp eye for fashion.
I'd say we've earned a butterbeer or two, wouldn't you? Might help me forget that I was almost pulverized by a troll.
I'd say that I agree with you.
Perfect. The three broomsticks is just this way.
I sell even more battle-worthy items, should you be inclined. You're most
yeah,
welcome
I mean,
to book
so I can see that, but this green one is actually more powerful than that blue one that I had, right?
Assuming it isn't utter bedlam in there, you might even meet Serona, the owner. She's a good one to know.
No, I got you. Yeah, you can always change the appearance. That makes sense, too.
You said you could get to the child when they came to Hogsmeade. That all you needed was a distraction. I gave you a distraction.
I just watched a student take down your distraction. Who is this child? What are you not telling me?
All you need to know is that if you cannot get to the child, then you have no value to me.
Let's go.
Did they see us?
I don't think so.
What was that goblin doing with Victor Rookwood?
Ranrock is working with Rookwood.
The goblin from the Daily Prophet. I knew I'd seen him somewhere. Quickly, let's get inside the three broomsticks.
It's a treat to see you, Lord Gok. I shall let you know if I hear anything. Thank you, Serona.
You be well.
Now, what can I... Oh, there's a face I haven't seen before.
It's my first time here.
Welcome. Butterbeer's on me. Heard about the attack. I shall be looking in on the other shopkeepers and residents shortly. Glad to see you two escaped injury.
Thanks to this one. Single-handedly took down a troll.
Is that right? Well done.
Thank you for this.
My pleasure. I will say, trolls in Hogsmeade. That's never happened before. Something's not right. The only brutes we usually have to deal with are... How timely.
Was that Lodgok I saw leaving just now? Your clientele's not what it used to be, Serona.
Not to worry, Victor. Once the two of you leave, the caliber of my clientele will greatly improve. I wouldn't do that if I were you, Theophilus.
Come now. No need for theatrics. I'm only here for this one anyway.
My friend is enjoying a well-earned butterbeer.
Only want a quick word.
Perhaps you didn't hear me. I said, my friend is busy.
One would think you all had enough bloodshed for one day.
I like the game. It's been good so far.
The three broomsticks isn't what it used to be.
Excited to keep playing.
Let's take our gutting
play it further.
Can't drink butterbeer.
I've been playing
forever.
It for, what, 3.5 hours now, and y'all have stuck with me, so this is good. I love it.
Seems you've made an unfortunate enemy. Watch your back. Rookwood and Harlow are worse than any troll you might encounter.
Trolls? Ranrok and Rookwood? What are you not telling me?
I promise to tell you everything. It is perhaps best I do that later.
And on that note, I think we should head back to the castle.
I'm certainly glad Serona was there. Told you she was one of the good ones.
I can see that. She didn't seem at all intimidated by Rookwood and Harlow.
I think you'll need to tell me why Victor Rookwood has you in his sights. But we can talk later. For the moment, we should return to the castle. Professor Weasley's certain to hear about the troll attack soon if she hasn't already. Don't want to risk another detention for getting back after hours.
Yeah, so I was getting ready to cut it out as soon as this loads up and saves and everything like that. I can drop this and go full screen. Thank you all for joining. I'm gonna be streaming more. Obviously, I have the setup. I'm excited for the setup that I have, everything that's going on. But I appreciate y'all joining in. So, So Y'all have a good night. Thank you again. And if you don't already, follow me across all social media platforms. And we'll chat later. And thanks. All right. See y'all.